Homegrown alligator, see you later. Gotta hit the road. Gotta hit the road.
Hey there guys, it's Paul from DroneGrid.com, and this time around we're having a look at a foldable drone from Sima, one of the most popular companies in the toy drone industry. It's called Sima Z1 and it comes in this small box, so it can't be that big, right? It does come with prop guards, spare propellers and a screwdriver to mount them just in case. The drone itself looks somewhat like a black Dobby in my opinion.
Oh yes sir, Dobby understands. It's just that Dobby has come to tell you it is difficult, sir.
Not that Dobby. Probably because of these foldable props that look pretty nice. The design lines definitely remind me of a sports car, even the lights are somewhat from a futuristic car. The camera of this drone is 720p and can be manually tilted before you fly. It comes in the package with one 500mAh battery and a pretty nice USB charger. If you want more batteries when you buy this drone, check the description down below. The flight distance for the drone is pretty much the basic Wi-Fi range. That's usually about 50 meters, but can be doubled with a cheap $10 Wi-Fi repeater like this Xiaomi one. The drone also comes with a tiny optical flow camera down below that will take pictures of the ground constantly and it will keep it in place. Let's take it outside to see how well it flies. Just letting you know, the day I took this footage, the wind was quite intense. The app is pretty well made and seems to be the same for some of the new Sima drones. It records everything on the phone from where you can share directly on social media. The drone was very stable in the air, I was quite surprised considering the wind. However, it felt like the controls weren't as responsive as I would have liked them to be. A beginner would have a difficult time controlling this drone precisely. Same day, even stronger wind, I wanted to test the camera quality, but as you can see from afar, it's quite hard to get face details, for example. However, a thing I liked a lot about this drone is that I managed to fly about 9 minutes with one battery, which is much more than I expected. The stability indoors isn't that good if there's only artificial lighting. It was even better outside, strangely enough. I also tested the noise level to see how annoying it is for people when you fly near them, and I got about 78 decibels, which is almost about as loud as a phone ringing. Let's go to the benchmark image and see how it compares to other drones. The selfies and photos you can take with it are good, but nothing exceptional. As a quick conclusion, this drone is a pretty stable flyer, but I wouldn't recommend it for beginners because I don't think it has smooth controls. It's pretty easy to use and set up, so that's no issue. The camera is average, nothing out of the ordinary, pretty much what I would expect at this price. In my opinion, this drone is a little bit expensive for what it can do. I recently reviewed other foldable pocket drones like the JJRC H61, which is almost half the price of this and it does the same thing. You can check that review over here or in the description. I'll also leave links down below with my favorite drones and more. Actually, for about the same price, you can get something like the DJI Drone X that takes amazing pictures and quite nice videos. Please leave a comment down below and tell me what other drones you want me to review, and I may take your opinion into consideration. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell notification icon if you want to see future videos from me. Thanks for watching and see ya later, alligator.
Homegrown alligator, see you later. Gotta hit the road. Gotta hit the road. The sun ain't changing the atmosphere, architecture unfamiliar. I could get used to this.